Welcome to IT Carlow. It is the Electric Ireland Higher Education GA Fitzgibbon Cup semi-final. NUIG awaiting the winners in the final back here on Saturday. Are you all ready for this? That's the question I'd ask. The tunes are absolutely pumping. You wouldn't think that students would recognise these, but they love it. It was the same last week, or last night, I should say, for the Electric Ireland Sigerson Cup final. With me for this game, former IT Carlow student and former member of the Fitzgibbon Cup panel of IT Carlow, and of course, a man who reached Fitzgibbon Cup final with what was then called CIT, Cork Institute of Technology, now MTU Cork Campus, Aidan Taggy Fogarty. Aidan, how are you?
Oisín, how are you? Delighted to be here tonight. Fierce excitement and just a great competition. Just delighted and can't wait to see the games get started.
Given your recent history, are you tempted to dance to these tunes?
My dancing days are gone, Oisín, I'm afraid. So I'll stick to the hurling for now.
Okay, well, it is going to be some amount of talent on that field tonight. Two-time finalists, IT Carlow. They've never won this competition. If they get through to the final, it will be at home on Saturday. I don't think they've ever had a better opportunity. For UL, they're six-time winners. They haven't won it since 2018. NUIG making interested spectators this evening. The warm-up's ongoing for IT Carlow. Well, this is a big opportunity, and they're at home, and that is a significant boost to them in a game this big.
Look, Oisín, I think home advantage is huge in a game like this. It's huge in any game. But look, all the college from Carlow are going to be here tonight. The stand is nearly full over there. You know, it's just your own ground. You know as a player every inch of that pitch. You don't want to lose in your own backyard. And that's what they're saying in there now, I guarantee you. I see UL are out kind of poking around there, warming up for the last 10 minutes. IT Carlow, I've been inside for a long time. They're out on the pitch just about 5 minutes, so they're well up for this game. And look, they've been in finals and never won it. IT Carlow, they're in a final in 2017, lost to Mary I, in a final in 2020, lost to UCC. So this has to come eventually. It has to come eventually, and it's made up for them tonight. Great team here in front of us on both spectrums.
The DJ did the wedding thing, turning down the mic at the 000 bit. Fergal Hayes, Podge Delaney, Jerry Kelly, Cahal Dunbar, Rory Higgins, Chris Nolan, Seamus Casey and Shane Reck, all involved in the last IT Carlow team to get to a final who didn't manage to win it. Does that have some significance as we look at the teams? And I can tell you, some late news filtering in, Jerry Kelly's appeal has failed, so he will not start tonight for IT Carlow. Cian Kennedy, who played for Kilkenny at the weekend in their defeat to Tipperary, is beside Owen Gunn, who's a hurler who's building a reputation all the time with Laois. It's a very solid full back line of Howland from Wexford with Podge Delaney wearing the number 3 jersey. He's an established senior inter-county hurler, and in this competition, that kind of experience cannot be understated.
It's huge. Any inter-county player now playing at this level, they should stand out a mile. You know, there's a good mix in that team all around from 1 to 15 of inter-county players, plus really, really good club hurlers as well.
Marty Kavanagh is named at 11. We're still not sure if he'll start or not. He missed the game for Carlow over the weekend. They lost to Westmeath, or they beat Westmeath, I beg your pardon. He was injured 11 minutes into last week's quarter-final win against UCC. He'd be an incalculable loss. If he's not there, they still do have scorers. They still do have shooters. Rory Higgins, Chris Nolan and Seamus Casey all capable of getting goals, Taggy.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. But look, Marty Kavanagh, I think, is central. He's named at 11 tonight. He went off last weekend with a groin injury, and a groin injury are so hard to get right in a short space of time. Huge hurler for St Mullins and a huge hurler for Carlow. And he can dictate around the middle if he plays, but he will be a huge loss. As I said, any inter-county hurler like that is a huge loss of the team. But in fairness, you do have Seamus Casey, Rory Higgins and Chris Nolan, a very dangerous full forward line. But I'd be interested in the half-back line. Jason Clear, Niall Brazzett, two Kilkenny men. I know I'm a Kilkenny man myself, but a very strong-looking half-back line there. And that's the way Carlow's set up. They're really hard to beat.
A lot of familiar names in this UL team. Owen Davis has quite the reputation at underage level with Cork. The St. Catharines man is a very decent young hurler. TJ Brennan, already part of Henry Shefflin's plans in Galway. Cian Galvin, we know all about the Clare Castle man. He is one of those players that falls into the bracket of experienced inter-county star even at such a young age. Killian Sampson of Offaly, also very decent. Corcoran replaces Brian O'Sullivan in the centre. The Kanturk man is on the bench. Watch out for number 14, Mark Rogers from Scariff and Clare. He's scored 5-3 so far in this competition. He's got Mikey Kiley of Waterford beside him. Besides Mikey Kiley, it has to be clarified because there's two Mikey Kileys in the Waterford team. Also, at wing forward, Niall Brennan, Liz Downey of Kilkenny. He scored 10 points in the competition this year. He is one to watch.
Yeah, such a potent forward line. Niall Brennan, 5 points the last day. Mark Rogers slotted in 3 goals. I think the UL team have 12 goals in the competition altogether. So they are going for goals. They have goal scorers in Toomey, in Mike Kiley, and Garrod O'Connor from Tip. He's the free taker. He's very dangerous as well.
There was a few players we didn't mention in our team news piece. We could have talked about them all. If you're playing in a Fitzgibbon Cup semi-final, you're talented, and chances are you have or will play for your county.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, look, as I said, it's either inter-county hurlers established or else there's guys trying to make a name for themselves, really good club hurlers. And I can guarantee you every inter-county manager around the country is having a look to see how their own fare in this match here tonight. It's a statement. And club hurlers kind of play better with better hurlers, you know, so the inter-county people kind of bring them along. So it's a serious game ahead of us.
John Keenan from Wicklow is our referee. The captains exchange pleasantries. For UL, the captain is Brian O'Mara from Holy Cross, Ballycahill of Tipperary. For IT Carlow, it's Podge Delaney of the Harps in Laois. As we say, an established county star. How much of a part does the atmosphere play here tonight, Taggy? It is electric. It's one of the best atmospheres I've experienced at any game for quite some time.
Yeah, it's absolutely fantastic. I don't know whether to go to the nightclub or stay here and watch the match, but it's absolutely brilliant, and especially for young guys. Young lads love to just play hurling off the cuff, and this is what this tournament is kind of about. They were probably out after the last match, getting an old team spirit there together. You know, out again probably tonight. Well, the final's actually Saturday, so we know going out tonight, but it's just kind of off the cuff. The pressure is off. You know, it's just go out there and hurl. There will be tactics, of course, but the music in the stand is playing into everything that's here tonight. Great atmosphere and just a really exciting game.
Owen Cody is another man that could start for IT Carlow tonight. Not named in the team, but if he's fit, he'll play. We saw on the other side there, number 33, Dara Corcoran, part of the Ballyhale Shamrocks team that lost the AIB All-Ireland Club Final last weekend. There's a couple of players in that bracket who were part of that game for Ballyhale Shamrocks. It's the best thing for you to come back and play straight away and be part of a big game straight away?
Look, I think so. Look, after losing a huge match like that, obviously you're down and out. But as you said, Oisín, the best thing to do is get back on the boots, get back out in that field, and, you know, just play the next game ahead of you, because what's done is done now. It's now to just move on and put that to bed. And that's what he'll do here tonight. I can't see Owen Cody, if he's fit, not to start here tonight.
Chris Nolan with the white helmet wearing number 14. If he played for, no disrespect to Carlow, a Kilkenny, a Tip, a Waterford, a Limerick, the nation would know about this guy.
Yeah, fantastic hurler. Has all the attributes. Big, strong man. And as you said, he'd be on any county team in the country. So big eyes on him tonight.
Although, as we all are aware now, after two losses in the league, it's done for Limerick. Pack up the tents, head home. You've had a great run of it. Same as the Dublin footballers. Good night and good luck. That's a joke, by the way. I was talking to Seamus Hickey today about that, and we had a bit of a giggle about it. He thinks whoever comes out of tonight, it doesn't matter. The game against NUIG on Saturday will be an absolute belter. It's a game you can watch on TG Cahir. Here comes the national anthem, and then it is the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup semi-final. He stole my line.
Was that you, Oisín?
No, that was not me. That was DJ Otzi, or the pizza man from Atlantic 252. if you're under the age of 30, ask your parents what Atlantic 252 was. It was when you were willing to listen to music with crackles in it. Yeah. IT Carlow taking on UL. And to quote my good friend on the far side, here we go. The conditions, by the way, are perfect. We know what's coming weather-wise. This is very much the calm before the storm. Normally, I say that as a cliche, but I think it literally is.
No, it is. Conditions are good. Pitch is in good nick for what it is. And it is actually very calm out there for the minute.
At the moment, it is. In every sense, it's calm. UL looking for an early score through Cian Galvin, which they have got. Cian Galvin, he excelled in the Electric Ireland Minor Championship for a couple of years, and now he's stepping up at adult grade, senior grade, county grade, Fitzgibbon grade, every grade you can imagine, he'll do it. That was quite the early bounce for UL, wasn't it, Tiny?
Yeah, no, absolutely, yeah. Cian Galvin just went up by the sideline and slotted Lord Barrett on his left-hand side, and that's another score there by UL.
That's a fantastic long ranger. One from the left, one from the right. And UL have got off to a very good start.
Yeah, fantastic score all the way out the field. Just dropped it straight over the bar. Brilliant score and a great start by UL.
Slipped out of the hands of Chris Nolan. IT Carlow trying to dig it out. These rucks, so important in the modern game. Seamus Casey over it there, but it is Corcoran, the Kilkenny man, trying to get away from Nolan. I think he got that one away one-handed. That's quite a puck for one hand. IT Carlow fumbling around in the centre, trying to get it up into his hand is Jason Clear. Jason Clear, a Kilkenny regular. His hand pass was difficult to take, but Owen Gaughan, much to his credit, took it but then lost it. Billy Power of Waterford tries to get it back. Luckily for him, he does get it. The Clonay man looking for options. Dispossessed by Owen Gaughan. That's really good work by Cian Kenny, Kilkenny man. Well taken, out in front. Can he turn? Rory Higgins. It's a miscue, and it's Killian Sampson of Offaly. I'm sure Michael Fennelly, your old teammate Taggy, will be watching him very closely. Offaly, yeah, in Division 1, looking to grow, looking to develop. UL looking for a free, which they have got.
Yeah, just a free out, just the tackling. But it's interesting to note, Oisín, on both sides. Both teams are playing a two-man full forward line, just sitting on the square and breaking out. And they have a kind of a sweeper mode just behind the half-back line. And that's on both sides, so they're both playing two-man full forward lines.
Michael Dempsey watching on the free to be taken by Garrod O'Connor, who scored 124 so far. It's over the bar. It's a good one from Garrod O'Connor.
That's a super score, Rushin, all the way on his own. It's only his own 60 there. And the night, it is a cold night, so that slitter won't travel as far, but that's a super score.
Adam Howland in goal for IT Carlow. UL winning all the breaking ball at the moment. So far, very much on top. Kieran Connolly let it out for Brian O'Grady. That's a solid looking strike from O'Grady.
They're unsure.
The umpires, yeah, they were unsure, but then they said, yeah, it's over. O'Grady with his first.
UL well on top, willing all the rocks, making all the runs. The ball off the shoulders, working really well for him. And Carlow just trying to get terms with him at the minute.
What a strike that was. It's just not going IT Carlow's way at the moment, but...
Oh, that's a score they should have got, really. He was on his own. He had more time than he had. He was on his own, really, and he should have stopped and hit it. But, yeah, they need to get a score on the board.
And that was Owen Cody, so there is the confirmation. He does start as we expected. That's fumbled out over the line. A bad mistake by Killian Sampson. I confused my midfielders early doors. Gaughan is wearing 9. Kenny is wearing 8.
Yeah, they're trying to confuse us there on jerseys. In
fairness to them, it was my mistake. Cahill Dunbar of Wexford. One of the crew who lost the final in 2020 in heartbreaking fashion against UCC. He's got the air on that, but not the accuracy. It just isn't going between those posts at the moment for IT Carlow.
No, but look, there's only 4 minutes gone, so look, they just have to settle into it there. That's the thing with line balls. Do you play them short, do you play them long, go wide, you're the villain.
Owen Davis released it to Sampson. Corcoran, long direct ball. You see a bit more of that in Fitzgibbon Cup hurling. Kylie guides it over. They're on fire at the moment.
Yeah,
Kylie now on 212 for the competition so far this season.
Look really sharp, UL, don't they, Oisín? Like they're playing great ball in the full forward line and taking their shots out the field.
Kylie, a Waterford regular, All-Ireland semi-finalist last year. He was mostly off the bench, but you can expect him to start a lot more this year. Who's going to win this race? It is won by the IT Carlow man, who's gone to ground, and it's Seamus Casey who won the foul.
Yeah, he was head down and going for goal, and just seemed to be like a tangle of the legs, really. But he swung across them, and yeah, it was a free in for sure.
Casey has got two goals so far this season in this competition, so he would have had goal on the mind had he been allowed to take that one into the hand. I think he'll pop it over for a point here.
Yeah, I couldn't see a reason for going for goal this early, so popping it over the bar would be the safest option.
And he gets that scoreboard ticking over for IT Carlow. I know I'm borrowing some phraseology from rugby there, but it is important, isn't it, to get off the mark?
It is for sure, because you actually kind of get nervous that you're not scoring, and especially with the other team scoring so much. You just want to get on the mark, and you want to get onto the scoreboard.
You can hear the clash of the ash from here. It's a beautiful sound, releasing the shot. Connolly from Lochmore Castellini. What a year he had last year. It's wide.
Yeah, he just snapped that. It really came up lovely to him, but just snapped that. Sharp puck out there by Carlow IT.
IT Carlow going direct. Hoovered up on that far side by Higgins, who's after losing it. That's really strong tackling, and now sweeping in is TJ Brennan. Brennan looks like he has all the attributes as UL work it out. Corcoran firing it long. Coming out to meet it, Mikey Kiley. In hot pursuit is Podge Delaney. Kiley looking for another one and not getting it.
Just why good pressure there by Podge Delaney, the full back. But once again, UL playing that brilliant ball and the composed ball into that full forward lane.
I'm sure those two will be sick of the sight of each other, Kiley and Delaney.
Waterford
playing leash at the weekend. Waterford winning well, but Delaney, quite the fullback. That's a fantastic catch by Chris Nolan. Nolan looking for their first point from play, and he's got it.
Absolutely brilliant point. Badly needed a point from play, out in front, caught it, took on his man, and over the bar on his left. Brilliant score.
It's just beautiful to see that, isn't it?
Yeah. No, it's brilliant.
And while you're watching that last one, IT Carlow are trying to create another one, which they haven't. Marty Kavanagh not in the starting team, by the way, just to confirm. We may see him at some point.
Yeah, the groin injury is so hard to get right in such a short space of time.
Kieran Burke of County Offaly has started for IT Carlow, the Ballinamere man. It's good work by Rogers. And tapped over by O'Connor. Clare and Tip working together.
Yeah, once again, they just UL just seeing powerful. They're taking on the challenge, but the ball is coming so good from out the field. That's very hard for that Carlow full back line to deal with, because it's just dropping in front of him. A very hard ball to defend.
That's picked up very strongly by Owen Gaughan. Jason Clear. Is that a shot or is that a dipping ball? It ends up as a dipping ball, which Owen Davis has the measure of. But then it's intercepted. IT Carlow with the chance here. It's Nolan. Nolan goes for it and hits it over. I have no doubt he was going for goal, but he just couldn't keep his shot down.
That's a serious chance, Chris Nolan. I think he should have went for goal. I'd say he possibly did, but just went over the bar. Should have stuck at the ground, really, but a mistake by the goalie, Owen Davis, and straight into Chris Nolan. And look, he should be scoring a goal from there.
UL winning the free. Running onto that ball was Kieran Connolly. I'm sure he would have let one go, but he doesn't have to. And they'll strike the free, and it's scoreable. There is no breeze to speak of at the moment.
Very calm conditions, Oisin, considering what the weather forecast was for tonight and tomorrow.
Gerald O'Connor of Moyne Temple Tui.
Great free taker, this man, the Tipperary man.
The sod in absolutely perfect condition, despite the fact that the Sigerson final was played here last night in horrific conditions. That looks like it's veering wide. Third wide for UL. That's a very good and clever take, trying to turn as Casey. Trying to get away from Corcoran. Casey's still going. He's got options inside, one of which he tries to go to. Somehow they keep the attack alive. Gone. Keeper has to be careful and isn't, and it's flicked in. It was a really clever finish by Seamus Casey. His third goal in this year's Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup. It could be the goal that sparks IT Carlow into life.
Yeah, such a fortuitous goal, really. You know, he went to put it over the bar, got the block on it, and I suppose like any good corner forward, he was hovering in around the goal, and he just got that flick to it, just got that hurl to it, and into the back of the net. That could spark IT Carlow here.
He's such a poacher. And there he is again. No, I beg your pardon, that's on the other side. That's Rory Higgins. It doesn't matter which one of them it is. They have the same helmet. They both play corner forward. They can both get very good scores.
And just like that, Oisín, 4 points swing, and IT Carlow 1-4, UL 6 points. Pint in it.
That's hurling. Trying to sweep in there and get the ball is Burke. Very strong Burke, but he loses out, and here's Garrod O'Connor. Not a man you want to give any kind of possession to anywhere near the goal, and that is what I was going to say, that's why, but unfortunately for UL, it's a fourth wide.
Right. Unlike Garrod O'Connor, to be fair, usually he slots them over the bar, and it was an opportunity.
Corcoran spills it. Burke. That's a shot, I've no doubt about it, but it might turn into a dropping ball. Trying to keep it alive is Higgins, he can't. Very good defensive work there. It's slotted out to Conor Flaherty, who is part of the UL team that lost the Sigerson Cup here last night. The final played against NUIG. NUIG, much to their credit, played well. UL weren't bad, but NUIG just with a bit too much in the end. Rogers. Free in. Rogers has put up some scoring totals so far in this competition. 5-3 so far. He's been pulling up trees for Clare as well. Yeah. It's quite a time for Scariff, the Camogie team. Scariff and Ugonaloo are in an All-Ireland semi-final this weekend, having recently won the Munster title. A second Munster title in 3 years, I think. Garrod O'Connor will take the free.
Some are saying wide.
And that's why I held on. Yeah. Because I said it looked wide, but it couldn't be. He's arguing it.
It looked wide,
If we had Hawkeye, which we don't, we'd be going to it. But
he's arguing, but he's not arguing. It looked like a score on the telly, but I think it looked wide. It is wide. They're giving it as wide. Bad miss.
Smacked forward by Kieran Connolly. That's a wonderful point from Kieran Connolly of Loughmore Castellani.
That's unbelievable score all the way out the field there tonight. You know, fabulous score.
Worth another look.
Yeah.
Cian Kenny drags it wide.
Yeah, Cian Kenny played very well for Kenny there last weekend as well. So very strong midfield Carlow had, but that's just a wide by him.
From what you know of Brian Cody, how closely does he pay attention to this competition and what does he take from it? Does he learn a lot about players? Will players get a chance if they show well in this?
Yeah, look, he wouldn't tell you he'd be at the matches, but for sure he'd be keeping an eye on things. And as I said, it's probably a level down from Intercounty Hurling, so of course he's going to be taking something from it. And anyone that performs strong in this level competition is going to be able to shout.
Chris Nolan ran out of pitch. It will be a line ball to UL, which will be taken by Brian O'Grady. No, it's gone the other way. It's a line ball to IT Carlow to be taken by Seamus Casey. It's actually a free. I knew I'd get it right eventually. There was a push in the back in the lead-in, I think. Casey, who has a goal and a point so far. Making
Shrink.
A goal and 2 points.
Fabulous score. There was never in doubt, straight down the middle. And a brilliant free. Carlow just that little bit ahead in the last 5 or so minutes from that goal, just a little bit on top, and UL finding it difficult now to get the ball into the full forward line.
Flaherty went long back there defending for IT Carlow with Shane Reck. IT Carlow with the numbers back there, they have the possession. Fergal Hayes of Kilatangan and Tipperary. Might break for Nolan. Doesn't break for Nolan, does break for Cody, but he couldn't take it up into the hand. Cody twice Young Hurler of the Year. And now the committer of a foul on Brian O'Mara.
Yeah, definite foul there. Just held him back with his left hand, no doubt about it. He was breaking away and free out to UofL. Yeah, you can just see it there. Yeah, he's just holding him on it with the left hand.
At the moment, conditions warm and mild. Brian O'Grady.
Point.
That's a fantastic point from Brian O'Grady.
You know, we talk about the full forward line, Oisín, but all the points are coming out the field, you know, from UL. Kieran Connolly, a pint. Brian O'Grady, 2 points from wing forward. Keane Calvin from wing back. So a lot of scores from UL coming out the field, long range scores.
Down the park it goes from Fergal Hayes. Was there a little push in there? IT Carlow seemed to think so. They have the possession. Higgins.
Well, he's not going to give that if he didn't give the other one.
Mike Goff pickpockets him, and it's a free out.
Yeah, it was a push in the back, I think, at the start, but he didn't give it, and free out for you well.
Davis. A big call on the goalkeeping front because Dean Mason is on the bench. Mason,
yeah,
losing a senior championship game of hurling with his club for the first time last weekend. The All-Ireland final. He's got quite the record, doesn't he?
Quite the record, that. I wouldn't mind that.
Dunbar. Eyes up the post. Has a go. And why not?
They're giving it wide. Yeah.
Well, they took their time.
They took their time, but a wide, yeah. Wide by Cottle Dunbar. It looked to be over the bar. And he hasn't been in the game. Well, the half forward line in general is kind of out of the game for IT Carlow.
It's gone straight out of play. It will be a line ball. Anthony Nash, part of the UL management team. That was very casual and it works out well for UL. It's Garrod O'Connor. Can they get the shot away? The answer is yes. It's Cian Galvin again. And it's a point again. He's a sniper, isn't he, Cian Galvin?
Yeah, the halfbacks are actually, when the ball is being attacked, the halfbacks are pushing right up the field for that hand pass out to him, and they're putting the ball over the bar. So it is working when they get the ball and the runner's off the shoulder.
Nolan. He can shoot from anywhere, Nolan, but he'll be disappointed with that. A big win for him and Carlow over the weekend. They beat Westmeath in Division 2. It was a win they needed, lost it down on the opening day up in Ballycran.
He will be disappointed with that, but the pressure was on, you know. He could have took it on the left, maybe.
That's a good take. Billy Power. Lovely pass inside. Can they finish the move? No, they can't. The shot was smothered. Kieran Connolly. Podge Delaney. Overcooked it ever so slightly, but it might work out. Dunbar. Dunbar couldn't get his pass right. And then he loses out to Killian Sampson, who moves it on to Mike Goff, who's fouled by Cahill Dunbar. Wexford and Clare coming together as they did at the weekend.
Yeah, the crowd not happy with that. I think they think it's a bit soft, but it was a free out.
Dunbar just tying up the loose ends. DJ Carey, the manager of IT Carlow. How much would he love to lead his college, his team, to a first ever Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup title? They've got to two finals, they've lost both. The final here on Saturday, a home final, if they can get there, but there's a lot of work to do.
Yeah, he's actually a really good manager, rushing for this level, at this college's level as well. Players buy into him massively, and they look for every word that comes out of his mouth. Super manager.
If you can't buy into DJ Carey as a hurler, who can you buy into?
Very true. The legend that is DJ.
I heard when Henry Shefflin took over Galway, he went around introducing himself to the players, which I found hilarious. Henry Shefflin introducing himself to hurlers.
He wanted to be under a rock there for the last 30 years.
Seamus Casey about to take this free, just inside his own 65, as you can now see. The stand absolutely packed here. And all around the pitch, there's people as well. Casey. Great strike from Casey.
Good score, right, Oshie.
But Oshie, it needs to kind of come to life. We're waiting for it to kind of explode, but it's nice hurling so far, but it hasn't really come into the depths of kind of hard, tough colleges hurling.
Kian Kenny is trying to help us with that, and he has. That's a very good score. Intercepted the puck out, put it over. Good point from James Stevens, Kian Kenny.
And that's what Kian Kenny is kind of a flamboyant hurler. He brings something different to it, in fairness to him.
He learned the flamboyance at James Stevens from Jackie Tyrrell, I've no doubt. Chris Nolan taking off. Chris Nolan getting the shot away. Chris Nolan getting the point. UL say wide. I have to say, I thought it was a point.
I thought it was a point by looking at it now. I did. It was right in front of us, Oisín, down the middle. And
what
it
did
like
you
a
think?
Pint. Yeah, I thought it was a point, to be fair.
In fairness, that's why the umpires are where they are. They're at a better angle.
Is that why they're wearing the white coats?
That's. Let's have a look here.
It looks. Well. Maybe at the last minute.
They don't have a replay either, unlike us. Garrod O'Connor with a one-handed sweep down towards Mikey Kiley. Line ball to UL. Garrod O'Connor.
Looking for a short one, but not available, so I'd say he's going to.
Well, he has the skills to go for it.
Yeah.
Doesn't catch it right, but it rebounds around dangerously. IT Carlow have dealt with it initially. And now breaking out is the defender who received it well. Dunbar is back a long way. And he lets the ball do the work, but there's no one up there. IT Carlow have dropped back an extra defender.
Yeah.
And when you do that, you risk pucking it away. But that's a very good interception. It's Casey again. Dunbar. If this goes anywhere near the post, I'm not committing to anything. I'm going to wait for the umpires, who say that it's a good point.
He wasn't happy with the last one, so he went for it this time. Great score. And it's after dropping, you're right, after dropping right back into their own half-forward line. But that's leaving the number six, isn't it? He's actually spare. Brian O'Mara there now, he seems to be spare. But it's going to be a spare man back there, so they have to avoid go down the they have to go down the channels rather than go down the centre.
Dunbar, who's driven by the hurt of 2020, although I spoke to DJ after their game against DCU Dokasaran, and he said it really is irrelevant. He said winning this won't make up for losing that. If it makes sense. Yeah. So he said, if players want to use it as motivation, fine, but it really has nothing to do with anything. Kian Galvin has been spoken to here, a former Electric Ireland Minor Player of the Year.
That's one thing with DJ, I always found, he never looked backwards. He always said, the next match, and whatever you want to use for motivation, use it, but that's not his style.
Casey will strike this one. What a magnificent job IT Carlow have done, by the way, of staging this. It's not just about the games in the Fitzgibbon and Sigerson, it's all the other finals and games that take place, and there's a great atmosphere around campus.
Super facilities here as well, absolutely fantastic. You know, they've built onto the college there the last couple of years as well, so fantastic.
Another good score, IT Carlow by 3, which is impressive considering the poor start they had. I think UL had scored 5 points in a row before IT Carlow got their first.
Yeah, but Carlow really got the grips of them now, and UL finding it difficult to get scores. Down to the free man.
Mike Goff going long. Kian Kenny playing a bit of hockey with it, but then losing out, taking it as Niall Brennan. The Kilkenny man taps it over.
I haven't seen much of Niall Brennan, actually. He scored 5 points the last day, and he's a very important to the UL side if they're going to come out on top.
They've only played 3 games so far this season, UL, because they were in a group that only had 3 teams.
And you'd wonder about that, Oshie. You know, UL probably had the hand of your side to draw, racked up big scores, so when it comes down to the wire, will they have it in them to get over the line?
Somehow Derek Corcoran got that ball away. Here is Brennan again, looking for 2 in a row, which he has got. Lovely strike of the ball from Niall Brennan. Again, the extra man for UL is able to take it at his ease. That extra man is Brian O'Mara. It was a good delivery, but he just couldn't hold on to it,
yeah.
Mark Rogers.
Popped out of hand.
That happens on cold nights. Good conditions, but it is still quite chilly out there. And that's a free in.
Three in. Looked a bit soft. He's not happy. Potch Delaney doesn't look a bit subdued, but probably held him with the right hand, but a little tug, all right. Probably a little soft, maybe.
Casey.
They nearly get the softer ones now than the harder ones, Oisin.
They're worse than the judges on Dancing with the Stars, are they?
Don't I know all about them.
Okay, that's my second Dancing with the Stars reference. I promise there'll only be one more.
I'll end up dancing at the end of this tonight, I think.
Well, you're a former IT Carlow student, so if they win tonight, you will be allowed to dance. But the players won't, because they'll have to play again on Saturday.
Oisin, if I'm out tonight, it's a sad case of affairs.
Nolan trying to get away from Brian O'Grady. He does. Oh, that's lovely. A lovely bit of trickery, a lovely bit of magic from Casey. Oh, and that's brilliant. Even better. Nolan sweeps it forward. Nolan looking for a shooting opportunity off the stick. Higgins was in there again, but just couldn't get his stick to it. And great. That is a wide for certain.
Great bit of magician work by Casey, you know. Trun the dummy and then the hand pass, and a pity that didn't go over the bar. It would have been scored the game if it had to.
It was TJ-esque, wasn't it?
Oh, fantastic, yeah.
TJ and Eve off on the honeymoon today. I'm not stalking them. They put it on Instagram, by the way. It's public knowledge. IT Carlow showing their strength here. Great work from Aidan Redmond looking for Nolan, but he hasn't found him. O'Mara intercepts. Mike Goff. Will it fall for Mark Rogers? It does. Is Rogers fouled by Shane Reck?
Just over Labbert, just the tangle of the feet, and that can happen. Anytime a player goes down and going to raise the ball and he falls, like 70% of the time they're going to get the free.
Wasn't too much in it, was there?
It wasn't too much in it, no. If he's coming out with the ball, you'd wonder would he give it. But you will have struggled ever since Dunbar came out to midfield and dropped deep. You will have struggled to get the ball in.
Slotted over wonderfully well by Mark Rogers. Adam Howland cushions his puck out. And that's a foul on Redmond as he makes his way out. The Rathnure man going to ground. Rathnure has produced so many good players over the years, as has Liz Downey, Noel Brennan's club.
Brilliant puck out there by Aidan Howland. You know, not easy on a night like tonight, but pinged it right into the hands and a free out.
And Casey is a long way out.
Yeah, he's coming back a long, long way.
That's between his own 65 and 45. It has the legs. This one went so long, it's picked him up air miles. That's a fantastic strike.
Absolutely brilliant score. Between his own 45 and 65, and I suppose you talk about the ball and the slitter and how light it is, you can't fault that for a score. Absolutely fantastic. Playing really well, Seamus Casey.
That's a very good taken turn by Rogers. But IT Carlow just wouldn't let him go, and were a little bit overzealous in their tackling. It's a free in, but the alternative of letting him run at goal was worse.
Yeah, look, if anything now, it was a bit clinical. He was going, he was at full belt, and he was going straight for that goal. So probably in the Carlow point of view, probably right to it, maybe bring him down. But in fairness, the ball was there. It was the number five there coming across.
Yeah, Niall Brazel.
Centre back for Kilkenny the last day came across. I think there's a shoulder into the chest, really, more so than the tackle from behind.
Good to see Brazel back, isn't it? He's had a bit of a struggle with injury.
Yeah, he has, in fairness now, yeah. Brilliant hurler, you know, from the village, and a lot of potential.
The village being James Stevens in Kilkenny. Home of Jackie Tyrrell, Owen Larkin, and a certain Mr. Cody.
Who? Who was the last one?
And I don't mean Owen.
Oh.
Or my dog, who's called Cody, after Brian Cody.
Is your dog after Brian Cody?
Yeah, well, it's my parents' dog, but yeah, named after Brian Cody. Mark Rogers taps it over. That's the respect they have from him. Waterford people calling him Cody. Mike Rogers, Mark Rogers, I beg your pardon, putting it over. Clare.
They're going long, straight to the full forward line into the big man, Mark Rogers.
Nolan is going to come out and try and meet that. He doesn't get it, but it does fall for IT Carlow. They're still trying to get control of it at Higgins. Dispossessed brilliantly by Kylie. Look at the strength of Kylie. And that's another free. It was more clumsy than anything else from Kieran Burke.
Yeah.
But he's going to get a speaking to from Keenan and possibly a card as well.
Possibly going to get a card here, I'd say. And Carlo are fouling just that little bit more. They're going in hard into the tackles and they're creating, they're getting a few frees from it.
Yellow card, Kieran Burke. Let's have another look. This is how he picked up the yellow card. That's the end of the incident. That's it. Kian Kenny, who he fell against, but it was Burke who committed the foul.
It's hard to see exactly what happened there, but it seemed to come across just too strong with the hurl.
Brian O'Mara. That looks straight and through. And it is Brian O'Mara from out the country.
Brilliant score. There's some exhibition of long-range scores here tonight, Oisín, in fairness, by all the players.
And it's all square at the break. At this point, I'll remind you that it has to end tonight. Extra time and penalties if required. UL with that last-second leveller at the end of the half. Who do you think will be the happier going in at the break, Taggy?
Yeah, look, I think, obviously, UL started very well. And we're 4 points up to no score after about 5-10 minutes. Then all of a sudden Carlow came back into it, got the goal by Seamus Casey, and that kind of set fire to him. So look, I think it's a small bit subdued. I think it still has to really set fire to it, but going in, I think for all the hurling, I think UL probably that little bit happier.
Level 5 times, it tells you exactly what kind of game it is.
Yeah exactly. Look, there's nothing between them, so look, it's all to play for in the second half.
IT Carlow 111, UL 14 points. More analysis of the first half and the second half to come live on the Electric Ireland YouTube channel. It is the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup semi-final. NUIG awaiting the winners. That game will be played here on Saturday. That will be live on TG Cahir. But for the rest of the night, stick with us and you won't miss a thing. IT Carlow 111, UL 14 points. still at half time here in IT Carlow in the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup semi-final. IT Carlow 111, UL 14 points. Aidan Fogarty, a former Fitzgibbon Cup player with IT Carlow, and a finalist with what was then called CIT, what is now called MTU Cork Campus. It's been an entertaining game so far, hasn't it?
Yeah, no, look, I think it started off, you know, belter of a game. UL really got into it, 4 points up. Carlow IT then obviously getting the goal, getting to grips with the game. So as you said yourself, Oisín, before half time, level 5 times, there's really nothing between the teams. I think both teams will be looking for a little bit more from their players. You know, Seamus Casey for Carlow has been the danger man, and he has, I think, is it 1-5 he has, and 5-5 to play. So he's the one, really the danger man. But they're looking for more of a spread around the half back. They need to get into a bit more for Carlow. UL, very physical team, but totally went out of it when they brought back the man. So UL are struggling with the spare man of Carlow IT. I think it was Cathal Dunbar was drifting out for a long time, really struggling with it. So they'll be in the dressing room. Carlow, I know for a fact, will be saying, "This is it, guys. Our own backyard. Look, our own crowd, we do not want to lose this one. It's there for us, draw a game. We haven't played to our potential, and it's there for us." And on the flip side, UL are probably saying, probably the very same thing, but I think there could be a little bit more hunger in that Carlow IT.
Is it fair to say that IT Carlow probably need to get more out of Owen Cody?
Look, for sure. Obviously, he could be a bit of a subdued from the All-Ireland hurling final there a couple of last weekend. So, look, you just don't know what kind of frame of mind he's in. The man, he can turn it on just like that in a second. So I would say leave him in there. He could just do damage in 2 or 3 seconds. We've seen it before in him. He could catch a ball and bury it, and that's all he needs to do. All he needs to do is stay in there, grab a ball and bury it. That's all he needs to do.
One man who is showing well for them is Seamus Casey. We saw his goal there a second ago. Rory Higgins in the other corner getting a good point. Casey has been sending over frees from all around the pitch as well. He has been key to IT Carlow's success so far.
Absolutely key to him, and you can see in the Carlow full back line, they look up and straight away they're looking for the corners. They're either looking for Seamus Casey or looking for Chris Nolan, who are hanging deep right on the 6 yard box. Rory Higgins is kind of drifting out, but they're looking for that full forward line, and Chris Nolan is a big man. We've seen him snap a ball from the sky already and put it over the bar, but what they're really probably looking for is a breaking ball from him and Seamus Casey to latch onto it. So both teams are actually playing very, very similar. Both teams are playing it that they want to get into the full forward line. And UL, in fairness to UL, they're getting a lot of scores out the field. So the runners are coming from deep. Keane Galvin, 2 points from play, by running from deep and looking for that pass. And he has a free shot on goal, and he's put 2 balls over the bar already. So UL, in that front, have been playing very well.
That man, Niall Brennan, came into it towards the end of the half.
Yeah, look, Niall Brennan scored 5 points the last day. He's a big player for UL, a Kilkenny man. 2 points towards the end, so that'll give him confidence, a big boost. And that's some of it as well. Sometimes when you're not kind of playing well, you need to kind of get into the game or get a handy score to get your confidence up. Because, look, there's a big panels here on both sides, so the changes will be made.
Long-range scores have been a real thing in this game. That could be what settles it.
Yeah, absolutely fantastic. I can see on the 59-60 minute, Oisín, a long score by Brian O'Mara, or, you know, the likes of a Podge Delaney coming up, has been phenomenal, the point scoring. And even when actually closer to goal, they've drove more wides closer to goal than they have out the field.
The atmosphere here, absolutely cracking, isn't it, Taggy?
Look, it's super. It really defines me for college's hurling. Look, the stand is full, the railing is full on either side as well, just looking across the field. The tunes are pumping, the lads are out poking around as they should be, and look, it's just real brilliant stuff, and it's really what college's hurling is about. Off the cuff stuff, off the cuff music, whatever you want to call it, and it's really enjoyable.
What do you the two teams change, if anything, coming into the second half or for the second half?
Look, it's really hard to know. No one is really dominating in any position. It's really tit for tat. So, like, if anything, it's probably just really small things like an extra bit of hunger.
Well, the big thing is do they sacrifice the spare man? Because at stages of the first half, both UL and IT Carlow dropped men back, or at least one.
Yeah, no, they did absolutely. And like, how do you play against that? How do you play with that? You have 3 men back there. I'd be suggesting that you just play it down the flank, you carry the ball into tackles, runners off the shoulders, rather than just hitting hope. But that's easier said when you have 2 men coming on you trying to get a block and a hook into you. So it really is hard to know. It's probably like 2 of them are breaking even on that front. You know, 2 of them are kind of playing in each other's hands, so there's no one really, really on top.
The goal, when it came, was not what you'd call the best goal ever, but it was one of the cleverest goals ever.
Yeah, really clever. You know, here we have Casey taking on his man, you know, brilliant speed, brilliant pace, eyeing the ball, and look, throwing it back into Nolan, who was it? No, it was actually midfielder, but went for the score. And there's a touch of class.
Yeah, got him with the shot. Yeah. And Casey just kind of snuck in there. Followed up his own move. That can't be understated how good that is to see from your forwards. If you're DJ Carey, that's probably what you want to see. Follow up on everything. 99 times out of 100, it mightn't come to you. But the one time it does, something like that can happen.
We do it in training every night of the week. You hit the ball and you move. That's the first thing you learn. You don't stand and hit. You hit and you move after the ball. And that's exactly what he did. But the awareness and the awareness he had of where the goalie is going to be. And he didn't swing at it. He just got a little flick to it. Kind of remind me even of DJ Carey against Clare. If you remember, Rushin, he just tipped across and into the corner of the goal. So look, just the awareness from him. But that's exactly what it is. It was actually the hard run and the hard work off the ball that got him that goal.
The Marty Kavanagh dilemma. He had a fitness test before the match. I'm not sure if he passed it, but he obviously didn't convince the management that he was ready for 60 minutes. If you bring him on, how big a risk is that considering the injury he has? I think it's a groin injury.
It's a groin injury, yeah. Very hard to get right. I suppose, Oisín, look, there's two ways of looking at it. If you're down by 3 or 4 pints with 3 or 4 minutes to go, I'd be bringing him on. You know, it's you have to show everything at it at that stage. If you're up five or six pints, there is no pint. And there, as we speak, Brian Cody is in the crowd. So you ask me, is Brian Cody interested in Fitzgibbon hurling? I can guarantee you.
Brian Cody is interested in all hurling. Here comes IT Carlow. Brian Cody, I wonder what he's making of it so far. I wonder what he would say to the teams at halftime. Or would he let the players lead it from...
It's amazing, Oisín. Like, you know, talk about managers, what are they going to say? The players have to take it over. The players are in the dressing room. It's them out in the field. Managers are obsolete at this stage. And it has to come from the players. Has to come from their own drive. And, you know, that's definitely the Brian Cody mantra. He steps back a lot of time in the dressing rooms. And that's what has to be happening in the dressing rooms there tonight.
And that's one of his players, Jason Clear from Bennett's Bridge.
Yeah, Jason was on the panel there and... Really, really great hurling. That's the thing, you can be off the panel there with Kilkenny or any team. You can be off the panel, show a bit of form, even in this tournament, and get back in.
IT Carlow are out. We are waiting for UL. There is DJ Carey, an ambassador for IT Carlow, the manager of the Fitzgibbon Cup team. He has talked about the difficulties of trying to get a team ready because you're not like a club or a county manager where you have them all the time and you can work on things.
So difficult. And I train down here with IT and with DJ Carey, and exactly what you said, Oisín. So many lads away with inter-counties, so many playing like under 20. You know, you have football, maybe guys playing football, so it's so hard to prepare. Literally, it comes down to maybe 2 weeks before it actually all kicks off, you might have a full team and know your full panel.
Marty Kavanagh is in for IT Carlow. Are you surprised that he has been brought in at this stage?
I am surprised he brought in stage. Look, will he last the 30 minutes? I would have definitely left it 10, 15 minutes to see how the game progressed and see how it would have opened up. I think it's a little bit early, but look, who am I to say? The decision is made. I wonder about how fit he is.
Now, here's the thing. Maybe he's doing it now and thinking to himself, if he's not 100% fit, well, he obviously isn't 100% fit, but if he's not fit enough to play, we'll know after 5, 10 minutes we can make another switch.
Well, look, that's it as well, yeah. But then again, it could be an impact sub there 5 minutes to go, you know, bring him on. As you said then, if he falls down 3 minutes after that, it is a letdown. So it's 6 of 1, half a dozen. Are they going to get a kick out of him coming on now? I would suggest maybe when the game is in full flow, bring him on. He brings something different to it, and even the crowd and the players can react to it.
He's impressed with his club and county down the years. He was a member of the club championship team of the season a couple of years ago. St Mullins getting to the Leinster final, beaten by Ballyhale Shamrocks. There is Mike Goff coming onto the pitch for UL, the cornerback who likes to play a bit of hurling, an intermediate county with his club last season, part of the Clare senior panel as we speak. And we're away for the second half. We will have extra time and penalties if we need them. But let's see, can the players end it within the half an hour? Extra time, while it would be exciting, wouldn't be great for either team because the final is on Saturday. It's not a huge turnaround time. UL trying to start well in the second half as they did in the first. Kylie's shot is smothered. At the very least, he gets a 65.
Yeah, definitely 65 there. Good block, kept the hurl up. But as you said, actually, very important. Nobody wants this to go to extra time. You know, you have NUIG coming on the back of last night's win. Injuries, everything else you want to avoid going into Saturday.
I think the teams certainly don't want it. The fans mightn't mind.
Oh, it'll be exciting, all right.
It certainly will be.
No real positional changes. I'm just looking out into the field there. They're still kind of lined up the same way. So the full forward is kind of pulled out. Two-man full forward line down below for IT Carlow.
Mark Rogers, who scored 12 for Clare at the weekend, 10 of them from frees. That's a very, very good strike and a very good start to the second half. Started well in the first half, now they've started well in the second half. Can IT Carlow respond? Well, they won't do it by poking the ball away like that. Connolly. Brennan looking for his third.
That's a fantastic looking score.
It took its time, but eventually got over. Good point from Niall Brennan. One of those ones that seemed to hang in the air for eternity.
Yeah, great start by UL now already. You know, only a minute and a half into the game, 2 points on the scoreboard and 2 points ahead.
A former Kilkenny minor goalkeeper, Niall Brennan.
That's right.
There's a lot of that players who kind of are interchangeable. Owen Murphy, the Kilkenny goalkeeper, actually won a Fitzgibbon Cup as a centre-back for WIT. That's a great catch by Kylie. Kylie gets the shot away. It's smothered. And he couldn't follow it up. He couldn't get in there, Billy Power. And IT Carlow lived dangerously and get away with it.
Lived dangerously, yeah. But great defending, in fairness. And brilliantly caught, though. Brilliant by Mikey Kylie. And that's what he can do, though. That's what he's brilliant. Take the right off the ball.
Just squirts out of Nolan's hands. Trying to get it up into his is TJ Brennan. And it's a free out.
Cody not happy with that, but definitely pushing the back. And they're a little, Carlow IT are a little bit overzealous in the challenge and giving away a few soft frees.
This was a goal chance, but he was wrapped up well by Delaney. Brilliant fullback play, and then tidied up nicely by Fergal Hayes. The two Leishmen doing very well. Sorry, Fergal Hayes is from Tipperary, but one Leishman doing well. Fergal Hayes of Tip doing well. Power. Trying to find O'Connor, and it was swatted away. Just getting in there was Kieran Burke. Here's Aidan Redmond of Wexford.
Poor clearance.
There are so many counties represented out there. Sometimes you get a bit confused, but that's Connolly of Tipperary, no doubt about that. And there's Cian Galvin of Clare, who sends it wide.
Yeah, you will. Just on the top at the minute, you know, IT Carlow playing a risky game there, but you will playing into that full forward line.
IT Carlow into the corner. Risky when you're outnumbered in there. Owen Davis, Killian Sampson. Sampson is capable of scoring, but not like that. They do try and keep it alive.
They kept it alive, in fairness, Casey. I think I got across. Or it was Kylie got across, sorry.
That's a launcher from Casey. Which goes wide. He was unlucky.
In fairness to Casey, you wouldn't begrudge him having a shot from out there. He's very accurate usually.
Are there certain players you say that to? Just you can shoot wherever you want.
Yeah.
Casey, who was a goalkeeper under Davy Fitz. Another one. Here's Niall Brennan, the man we mentioned earlier on, who was a minor goalkeeper for Kilkenny. Spilled out there. O'Grady, it's opening up for him. Can O'Grady do a Ruddle? No. Only Ruddle can do a Ruddle.
The shot was on. He should have took the first shot.
Here's Dunbar. Trying to get inside Mike Goff in the end. Just takes the long route. Takes the tough route. But takes
wide.
The wrong route.
They're very unsure is right, yeah. They're very slow to come to telling the points or not. But look, a goal opportunity down to one then. If Dunbar had to put that over the bar, it would have been possibly a 4 point swing. But obviously wide.
Well, they are taking their time on some decisions, but you'd rather that than them rush it and get it wrong. Brennan. It's rebounding all over the place. Brennan tries to dig it out. Referee.
Yeah, I said he handled it on the ground.
Yep.
He's trying to take a quick one.
Normally in nighttime games, you would use a yellow slitter. That isn't the case tonight.
No, and I prefer, maybe it's my old school, but I prefer the white slitter, but
Here's Mark Rogers. He'll tap this one over. Part of me thinks he'll go for goal, but he will tap it over.
No, he will.
It's a good score. Four from place balls now for Rogers.
I'm right in saying, Oisín, IT Carlow hasn't scored yet in the second half.
That's correct. They'll try and amend that. Dunbar. That's a good run from Dunbar, trying to get away from O'Mara. It's a strong run from Dunbar. He's over-carried us, and it's a free out.
Huge turn.
And it's a big win for Brian O'Mara. He gives it the full fist pump.
That's a big win. You know, IT Carlow struggling for scores now at the minute. Really need to put one over the bar. And, you know, in fairness to Brian O'Mara, stood with him. And that's a great team morale. Three.
That's left behind. That's a good block. Billy Power working very, very hard, trying to get the ball back. And while he hasn't got the possession, he has pinned IT Carlow right back inside their own 45, closer to their 20 actually, on the running track side of the IT Carlow GA grounds. You were able to do a few sprints at half time, Taggy.
I nearly pulled a hamstring too, actually.
Lovely little pass to Niall Brennan off the stick of Killian Sampson. Can Brennan complete the move?
That's great.
Yes, he can. Smooth hurling. Brennan on 4 from play now.
Yeah, we're just kind of saying he was kind of quiet in the first 20 minutes, but he's really up to turn it on now. 4 from play, playing really, really well. And UL as a team, whatever we've said in that dressing room, they're after coming out really on top and really hungry for possession.
Corcoran sweeps it up. Just like the first half, UL have started well. It took IT Carlow about 5 minutes in the first half to score. We're almost 8 minutes into the second half. Yet to see a point from them. Jerry Kelly, of course, out tonight. He's an incalculable loss as it's over-carried out of defence by Niall Brazel.
Yeah, huge loss, Jerry Kelly. The centre-back for any team is a huge loss. But look, UL are just getting these little wins. They're getting these little frees, you know, over-carrying there. The one free down below with Brian O'Mara. These little wins mean a lot in these matches. Small little turning points.
Mark Rogers. Smooth and straight and over the crossbar.
And you talked about Marty Kavanagh coming on at half time. He hasn't made an impact yet. I haven't seen him being on the ball at all, Oisín, so it's hard to know whether that switch worked.
Not so far. Fergal Hayes. That was risky and it didn't work, and it was swept up and sent into the path of Mark Rogers, who hits it wide. That's a let off for IT Carlow, a big one.
Yeah, big let off, and IT Carlow need to get on the ball. They need to get a score on the board, you know, just for their own confidence to get their game flowing. UL are dictating to them so far.
Dunbar misses out on it. IT Carlow have the possession. Forward it goes from Kenny. Chris Nolan. Nolan looking for options. He has one inside. That's Higgins. Scored a goal last week. He'll at the very least get a free here, surely. He does.
No advantage yet.
IT Carlow's last score was Casey's point in the 28th minute. They've had a long time to wait. And it will be Casey who'll end that wait. Well, if you're enjoying this or you're a fan of either team, why not tell your friends who might be interested in either college or hurling in general. Share the link now on all your social media channels. And we're delighted to have you along watching this match on the Electric Ireland YouTube channel. If you're watching this from a Carlow or kind of southeast perspective or Wexford perspective, you'll be a little happier now because Wexford's Seamus Casey has just made the game that bit closer. IT Carlow's first point of the second half.
Yeah, 10 minutes second half to get a point. They badly need a point, and UL are on the attack again. They're really pulling a jersey there. He couldn't even give it.
Kiley finally takes the advantage. Well, he doesn't take it, if you know what I mean. He got the advantage, but he was happy enough to play on Delaney with a little tug on the jersey. It was very, very obvious it was never going to be a miss.
No, very, very minimal there, but IT Carlow really struggling to get grips to this game. UL really on top, spraying the ball in, and even though they don't seem to have a free man. If I was IT Carlow, I'd bring back a man, maybe just swallow it up just for 5-10 minutes, just to stop the flow of UL.
Rogers taps it over, which he would have done with his eyes closed. Fantastic facilities here in IT Carlow. You can see the Astro behind. Behind that is a rugby pitch with a small stand. All the pitches in pristine condition. Marty Kavanagh trying to get into this. I think this is his first action. Doesn't look afraid to throw himself in and put his body on the line. That's a good sign. Doesn't quite work out on this occasion. But that, even those little things, that first involvement, that might get him involved.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, just to get him in the game. I know the ball's poked out to him, so I'm probably anxious to get him on the ball.
Owen Cody will contest here against Kieran Connolly. Niall Brennan leans over, trying to get it there. It's left behind and then picked up by Clear. Clear wants it back and gets it back. What a block that was. Really great work by the wing forward, Brian O'Grady.
Great work, but a bit slow by Cleary. He should have had that ball, got into the full forward line. Just took the touch, one too many touches.
It was a great ball by Brazel because he was absolutely surrounded.
Yeah, and now it's thrown in. So these little things, the referee's thrown in the ball there for just talk back.
It's right in front of our commentary position. Cleary is trying to gather it. Cleary keeps it going forward somehow. O'Grady gives him a shoulder. It's IT Carlow who get the decision. Cathal Dunbar. Well, they've got goals in their team. We know that IT Carlow, they don't necessarily have to get one, but they can't get
the thing is now not to panic.
Dunbar.
Ball.
It's just veering off, but it might stay alive. Nolan was in there, but he's lost to TJ Brennan under duress. Luckily for him, Corcoran was there, but he couldn't get it into his hand. Here's Nolan. Might have to pass it. Nolan doesn't pass it. Doesn't need to. That's a good score. A strong score.
Very good score. And in fairness, Chris Nolan, he's throwing his body around. He's getting on ball. He's doing his best. And look, he is the focal point of that Carlow IT attack at the minute.
I'd love to know the wattage generated by that collision between him and Corcoran there. UL looked to respond straight away. Billy Power. Good pass. And tapped over cleanly by Garrod O'Connor.
Yeah, look, another good score. But the scores are coming a lot more easier for UL. Carlow IT are really kind of struggling. Last minute kind of gasp to get a point. UL is flowing a bit more. The scores are a little bit more easier. You only tap that over the bar.
Brazel trying to get away from O'Grady. It squirts away from Brazel. Somehow he got it under control. Higgins, Dunbar. Plants the feet, dropped into the pocket nicely. Good score. They're beginning to roll now, IT Carlow. It's beginning to happen for them.
Well, it was like the first half. Oisín really like started off very, very slow. But look, a game of hurling, anything can happen. So they're definitely not down and out, and plenty of time to go.
No water break. Keep in mind that was a really strong win of the ball. Now what can IT Carlow do? Here is Casey. Very good work from Garrod O'Connor to get back and tackle. Casey gets it again. Dunbar, another block. This time it comes from Conor Flaherty as a goalkeeper who'd be well used to blocking. An All-Ireland under-20 football winner, a Leinster under-20 hurling winner. What a talented man he is. Not showing any ill effects from last night's loss to NUIG in the Electric Ireland Sigerson Cup final. An entertaining game which you can watch back on the TG Cahir player. Stepping inside is Rogers. Keeps it alive. Rogers misses.
Wide. I thought it went through the net.
That's why it took a second.
God, he really did all the hard work there, and God, he's so unlucky not to finish that.
The way he kept it going, kind of bounced it off the ground, and the turf is
such
good.
Such a big man.
IT Carlow, that's a let off for them. Can they take advantage of it? Mike Goff. It's a free in. The crowd beginning to make some noise. The players beginning to look a bit livelier.
Yeah, big score there for IT Carlow as well. UL were winning all them literally 5 minutes ago, and you know I can see the fist pump there. by Rory Higgins. It's them small things get you back in the game.
Well, last week, I'm sure it would have taken a lot out of these players beating UCC, but doing it with 14 in the end because Jerry Kelly was sent off. He's still suspended, can't play tonight. That's a good point from Seamus Casey. Then a lot of them would have played county hurling at the weekend. DJ Carey, always a calm presence on the sideline. Or maybe he just knows when the camera is on him. Here's Connolly.
He's probably cute enough like that, actually, mate.
That's wide. I don't know if it's too strong to say the momentum is now with IT Carlow, but certainly it's turned in their direction a little bit.
Yeah, they're definitely putting it up to more up to UL, in fairness. It's probably 50-50 now at the minute. Obviously, scoring difference there, but Carlow IT begin to find their momentum.
And they're beginning to work the ball as well.
And you will always get a purple patch, you know, and it's what you make in that purple patch is vital going forward.
Directed goes, well defended. IT Carlow, poor numbers in there to try and get the ball back. Brazza was trying to dig it out. Marty Kavanagh can't make it his. That's really good play from Brian O'Mara. O'Mara getting away from Higgins. Launching that one is Conor Flaherty. Great score from Conor Flaherty.
Fantastic score there, all the way out the field. Centre of the field and over the bar with lots to spare.
Well, I'm sure at inter-county level, being a dual star is no longer possible, but it is at college's level. Conor Flaherty is showing that. UL making a switch, coming in Ross Hayes from Crisheen and Clare. What a catch that was from Marty Kavanagh, but he just couldn't get away from Brennan. Has managed to pop it off to Clare, whose attempted through ball is intercepted. Flaherty again. It's left behind by the cornerback. I think that's Fergal Hayes. It is Fergal Hayes. Oh, he's brought down Billy Power there. It looked to me like he grabbed the helmet. So that would be a red if it was spotted. Well, we're playing on. Jason Clear with a cross feeler. Good pass as well. Adam Howland. Have IT Carlow just got a stroke of luck there?
Absolutely, yeah. So it was like a WWF throw to the ground there now. So it was. So they definitely got away with it.
Maybe, just maybe, that signals this is their night. Long way to go yet. Dunbar. Nolan, he'll fancy this. He had Dunbar running inside, but to be fair, Dunbar was covered and Nolan knew he could pop it over, and he did.
Great point by Chris Nolan. That's his 4 point from play, so he's doing damage in there when he gets on the ball.
Well, you give Chris Nolan that much time and space, you can expect to be punished, and they were.
Absolutely. Only 3 points in it now, Washington, after all the hurling you well done in the first 10 minutes.
What a player Chris Nolan is. Mount Leinster Rangers, man. Larnan Club finalist a couple of years ago. That's a fantastic catch. That's a team boosting catch. But then, as I say that, Niall Brennan intercepts the hand pass, but he can't make it his. They're winning the battles. Rory Higgins. That's a beautiful pass. Here's Nolan again. Looks to me like he's pulled that.
Pulled it, yeah.
Had a bit more time maybe than he realised.
No, he actually did. He came out the field a long way out there for it. So he's hungry for the ball. And look, there's 10 minutes to go. It's going to come down to maybe the fitter team, maybe the fresher team, and a few substitutes as well.
Speaking of freshers, congratulations to DCU, who won the Freshers Football Final earlier on against UCC. It was a great game, really entertaining, lots of scores. You can watch it back on the Electric Ireland YouTube channel. Higgins with a point that you'll no doubt want to watch back again. That was fantastic.
Oh, brilliant score. And you well are finding it hard to pick up their men. IT Carlow now are beginning to kind of roam around the pitch. You know, you had Chris Nolan coming out to half hour line, you had Rory Higgins kind of making a move. So I'd say DJs have to tell him, look, get on the ball, get away from your man, and you know, get it into the full forward line.
Brian O'Sullivan from Kanturk named to start. He didn't. He's in now. He's replaced Niall Brennan. His former club mate, Anthony Nash, part of the management team with UL. Kanturk, a dual club. They do fantastic work. Delaney. The defender does enough, gets it to Brian O'Mara. That was dangerous. Samson saves the blush of the man who passed it to him. Connolly. Connolly still going. Connolly off the stick.
Free
and
in.
It's a free in, yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Well, he probably knew he had the advantage.
Yeah, Keane Kenny giving out to the linesman there. But it seems to be him he's punishing, and he's going to give him a card by the looks of things.
Connolly, a player of the match in the county final last season, a big game player. Yellow card for Kian Kenny. Played for Kilkenny at the weekend against Tipperary, Kian Kenny. Mark Rogers, who's having a good night.
There isn't time wasting or waiting for something, but it'd be time wasting only 2 points up.
While we have a lull, how much of an advantage is it to NUIG that they have the extra rest day?
Look, it is an advantage, to be fair. Look, I know it's only a day, but a day means a lot. You know, tomorrow these guys are going to be very tired. It's going to be Friday, and next thing you're into a match on the Saturday, so a day is huge, really.
Just looking there, for some reason, Killian Sampson has run off. I haven't seen anyone come in to replace him. It looks like maybe he's getting some treatment, so it's possibly a blood sub. That's all happening off camera. What's happening on camera is Mark Rogers, as you can see, is standing over this free.
Yeah, it looks to be a blood sub.
Sails it over. Now this is a look at the earlier incident. Oh, they're saying it's wide.
Yeah, they gave it as wide. God, that's a huge miss.
It's a huge miss, and what it also has done is it stopped us showing, for now, that incident a couple of minutes ago with the potential helmet contact. We will come back to it, but we'll stick with play. IT Carlow, after a huge let-off, another one. Here's Owen Cody. Dunbar breaks it. Dunbar's gone down. Nolan's fighting for it. The referee is saying it's a free in. That's a big swing.
Big swing now. Missed there. Mark Rogers missed an easy free down here, and it's swinging up towards IT Carlow, a free in, which they should score.
Well, we were all sure it was over. Let's have another quick look at this one. Rogers with the strike.
It's hard to tell from that angle.
There's been a few incidents like that in this game. He's saying it's over. He looks surprised. You can tell a lot by a guy's reaction.
He looks surprised. And that's not the first time tonight that the decisions had been 50-50 and they weren't sure of.
But again, they do have a better angle than we do.
Yeah.
And they don't get a replay, unlike us. Here is Seamus Casey. IT Carlow creeping ever closer, 1 point between them, 6 minutes to go. I'll remind you once again, extra time and penalties if required. It has to end tonight.
It was always going to come down to a close finish, Oisín. You know, IT Carlow were never going to give up that easily. And look, as I said, 6 minutes to go, 1 point in it.
I was just about to tell you about Shane Staunton. His time has been so short, though. He's already going off. He came on as a blood sub. He replaced Killian Sampson, who's now wearing number 35. That's him. 34 in the panel. So as the blood sub, the first blood sub, you wear the next number up, and that's 35. That could break kindly for UL. Rogers. Off the line by the keeper. Not quite off the line, but not far off. And either way, they stopped the goal going in. Rogers unlucky. He's still down.
They're going to rue these chances yet, maybe, Oisín.
Corcoran couldn't make it his. IT Carlow tried to get it forward. Here's Casey. Loves dropping deep. Cody, for the first time in this game, getting a run. And getting a strike away. It's going to drop inside. Is that a penalty? Was there a foul? Dunbar. The referee, what's he deciding? Free out. He says there was a pull across.
Huge call. Oh, huge call. It was in the back of the net. Was there a penalty before that? Was the IT Carlow man brought down?
So here's Cody letting it in. Well, I think he was going for a point, but it dropped short. Nolan and Goff tangled. Was that Marty Kavanagh? Dunbar put it into the net. I think play was stopped, to be fair,
play
by
was stopped
the UL players.
It was stopped. He gave the free for swinging across the goalie. Dunbar, I think.
And Mark Rogers is at the other end of the pitch getting treatment.
Yeah. And that was such a tight such a tight angle. He nearly got it over, just didn't get enough on the slitter to get over the line. That's the second chance he had of a goal opportunity. Now the first one was obviously a bit easier, but that one was a chance also.
From this angle, because they both wear white helmets, they're both quite big, I couldn't see whether it was Nolan or Kavanagh in the square there who was under that dropping ball. But either way, IT Carlow would argue that they were fouled.
Yeah.
UL might argue that there was a tangle, the two of them went down and there wasn't anything in it. So what's the decision here? I'm sure John Keane is dropping back, wondering why Rogers is down injured. Maybe he's asking if there's anything more to that. Let's hope for Rogers he's okay, not just for tonight, but for Saturday if they get there, and then for Clare in the coming weeks.
Ah, exactly, yeah. You don't want to see... Look, whoever's in the final, you want everyone playing on Saturday.
Yeah.
On your best team out. He looks to be in bad way now.
At the very least, his night looks to be over. Let's hope that's all it is.
If there's a bell to be okay, yeah. If he went over on it, that's a bit more serious.
Well, there's been so many incidents in the second half. Well, that's not a good sign. We will resume. Samson. Good stick pass. Plenty of flight on it. Plenty of pace. Galvin, rather than shooting, went with the pass. And it's a free out. Mm.
They're getting all the decisions now, Oisín. Just like UL were getting in the first 10 minutes of the second half. IT Carlow seems to be getting them now.
I hope you've left some time in your calendar for extra time and potentially penalties. So this is that last ball in there. Was it a penalty or was it a foul on the defender? It looks like a foul on the defender.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Good call. Casey.
Well in his range.
He doesn't need to be that close to goal, does he? Judging by the sound of the crowd, they think it's over.
Massive
and
score.
And they are right. We're all square.
Huge score. Momentum with Carlow IT in Carlow IT. The crowd are getting behind him. Fitzgibbon Cup at its best.
This is it. It comes down to 2, maybe 5 minutes, depending on injury time. Goes over everyone, but running onto it is Brian O'Grady. O'Grady to put UL back in front, which he's done. Or has he? Yes, he has.
Over the bar, he has.
There was a second of doubt.
There'll be a good bit of extra time, Oisín, I'd imagine, with the few stops that happened in the second half.
That's the point that has UL back in front. Is this the point? If it goes over, that levels it. Chris Nolan, no. He's had a good night.
He was very good. 4 points of play. Anything that good came from IT Carlow came through him.
Well, whoever NUIG face on Saturday, they know it will be a battle. It is going to be live on TG Cahir. That looks like it's over. I think that's Kylie from a very tight angle. It's a 2-point game.
Ooh, brilliant. Great score.
Just Kylie using out. All his attributes.
Bounce
skill,
tackle,
strength,
yeah.
And the ability to shoot. IT Carlow, I don't think they need to go for goal just yet, but if the opportunity presents itself, it has, and they have. IT Carlow in front. What is it about this week in late goals?
Was it your man Marty Kavanagh? I'm not too sure. No.
Marty Kavanagh has barely had a puck since coming on.
But we said, would he make an impact?
He certainly has.
Some impact.
2 points in it. 3 minutes of injury time to play. Marty Kavanagh, the man of the moment.
That's what he does. That's what he's so intelligent. Just brought the ball down right in front of him. No, trying to catch it, flicked it on, and just the awareness to flick into the back of the net. Brilliant by Marty Kavanagh.
His third goal in the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup campaign of 2022. Is it the one that sends IT Carlow to the final for the third time? It will be on here. UL need possession.
Cody.
They haven't got it. Cody. He's calm under pressure. Great pass from Cody. Jason Clear.
Shot wasn't on.
No. I don't think he had many around him though. He couldn't pass.
No, but all he had to do maybe just hold on to it.
O'Mara farms it forward. UL have 2 minutes, which is plenty of time.
Carlow just trying to play it out, keep possession. Keep possession, as I say, as he launches it down 70 yards.
Cavan is under it. Goff does well.
Was that a free?
It's won by Sampson. It squirts away from Sampson. He's pickpocketed. This could finish it. It's own Cody. Great block. Goff got across. Cody might get a second bite of this. Sampson's in there to try and get it. Cavan is over it. Cavan does really well to just make it stick. Here's Mike Goff. Owen Davis.
Don't foul.
Flaherty just lets fly. It's going to drop.
Oh, what a score!
It's gone over the crossbar. Flaherty with an absolute monster of a point. It's not done yet.
What a score! 1 minute to go.
It's all over.
He's blown it up.
Flaherty got the last score, but it's heartbreak yet again for him. He lost last night in the Sigerson Cup final with UL. He's lost, unfortunately for him, with UL tonight in the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup semi-final. It is IT Carlow. No, it's level.
It's level. It's all square.
I lost the run of myself in the excitement. The full-time whistle went.
I was wondering, looking across.
I looked across at the scoreboard. Yeah. It's all square.
It is extra time.
It is extra time, and there is no heartbreak, not right now, for Conor Flaherty. DJ Carey, I don't think is what's
no,
he asking.
DJ is talking to the ref. He's actually asking, yeah. I think, about blowing up a little bit early. He was 50 seconds early, I think, for blowing that up. But Owen Cody had a chance. I know what he was thinking. He was looking across. He saw the IT man on his own in the square. He could have put it over the bar to make a two-point game, and he would have been champions for tonight. But it broke down. What a monster score by Conor Flaherty to draw it up.
Fantastic from Conor Flaherty. In a fairly hectic time, as the rain begins to fall, the storm is arriving, conditions are worsening, but hopefully it'll stay okay for extra time, which we have got 10 minutes aside here in IT Carlow. More drama to come. Aidan Fogarty.
So close. The last 10 minutes, Oisín, just a mirror image of the first half. UL came out and put 4 or 5 points up onto the board. IT Carlow struggled to get to grips with him and then really got into the game. And obviously the goal by Marty Kavanagh, what a sensational goal, to be fair. At the time he took it, the composure to take it, bring the ball down to himself, and then Conor Flaherty then.
But let's have a look at some of the highlights from the second half. What a second half it was. It was a bit slow to start, but when it got going, what a game. That was a great score.
Long range shooting by UL is just fantastic.
Chipping in there, Brian O'Mara. Garrod O'Connor. What a point this was. One of those long rangers that you mentioned, Aidan.
Yeah, no, like monsters, the points. And all the points we're looking at from UL have been well out the field, on the sideline. This one, like, you know, Brian O'Grady there again, sticking that ball over the bar. You know, just great striking the ball, especially on a night like tonight. I know the rain's beginning to come down and conditions were good, but it's still dark, it's still kind of winter hurling.
But played at a summer intensity.
Yeah, no, brilliant.
What a catch that was from Chris Nolan.
And this man for me, for IT Carlow, has been superb.
He kept them in it at times, didn't
he? Yeah, no, he did. Even when they were struggling, he was showing for the ball, he wanted the ball, he won the free, he got his point from play to bring Carlow onto the scoreboard.
This was an interception. And Nolan, well, he was going for goal. He had to settle for a point, though.
Yeah, he was definitely going for the goal, I'd say.
Seamus Casey, he's been brilliant as well. So many good performers out there.
Very good. And as you said, it was a follow-on run that made the score for this, you know, and the little tap in. Great. And actually, the two goals from Carlow IT have just been all about awareness and, you know, not panicking.
Higgins getting that point. They've just been going at it, haven't they? Score for score, especially in the last one.
It really has. When you look at it like this, actually, you can just really see it was end-to-end stuff. You know, nothing really between the teams. You know, UL getting on top, and then IT Carlow getting their purple patch, and then at the end, obviously, just the draw. But fantastic score taken.
Kian Galvin. Seamus Casey again.
He is some striker of the ball. He's some free taker from the field. Yeah, brilliant. And he looks like his heart looks really small. Looks like a little 34 or 33.
Kian Kenny. Chris Nolan again. It'll be interesting to look back at some of the close calls for points that weren't given in this game, but this one was. Dunbar, serious score.
There he is again. Yeah, it says a lot this time of year, Oisín, as well, for a really good free taker.
Yep. Brennan, he played well. He's off now. Got a couple of nice scores from play, Brennan. He's a good shooter.
Yeah, no, he is. He's four from play altogether, like, so he's... It's be all about legs now and freshness and...
How much of it comes down to, as you say, freshness? It mightn't necessarily be the big names, because those are the guys who've played an awful lot of hurling.
Yeah. No, it's someone maybe off the bench now, and I think it's kind of more kind of in the head, you know. It's composure in the head, yeah. Because you're tired. The thing to do is maybe put in for a lazy tackle, but you have to be so kind of mentally prepared for just to hold off, wait for that ball until it's shown. Don't be giving away lazy frees. You know, everything. Make that run. Make that hard run. All them things now. And so it's more of a mental thing, I think, for all these players out there. Physically, in fairness, physically, they're young men. They've been training, you know, for years, conditioning on them. It's very good. I know they're playing inter-county as well, and I know they have Fitzgibbon matches for the last 6 weeks. So it will take a toll. But really, it'll come down to a bit of hunger. It'll come down to mental ability. And it'll come down to who wants it more. So maybe a flash of brilliance.
There was some brilliance from this man tonight so far, Mark Rogers from County Clare. And Casey again.
Fantastic.
These are the best of the frees. There have been some excellent scores from play as well, including Chris Nolan. Took the bounce, took the hit, took the point. Billy Power setting it up, putting it over. Garrod O'Connor. Higgins putting it into Dunbar in space. He loves that little pocket, doesn't he, Dunbar?
He loves sitting down into it, yeah. Yeah.
So this strong is Mark Rogers.
This is a moment for definitely.
We thought that had gone through the net.
Through the net, yeah, absolutely, yeah. These little let-offs brought IT Carlow back into it. Gave them a little bit of glimmer of hope.
Flaherty. What a score that was. Not afraid of the big moment, Flaherty. And Rogers, so desperately close. Unlucky here. Keeper getting back. Taking the tackle from Brian O'Sullivan, which I'm sure he felt. Keeper let it slip.
Let it slip, yeah.
Dunbar, he got the ball in the net, but to be fair, the referee had blown the whistle at that point. Casey with another long
monster
ranger.
Monster score, this. Fantastic.
Good score from O'Grady. Mikey Kiley shrugged his man off, got the score. He's so strong, isn't he? Marty Kavanagh, here's the goal. This was the moment that many of the IT Carlow fans thought they had it won. But then Conor Flaherty did this to level it, even though not everyone at the time realised that, and by everyone I mean me. Did they have a mathematics course here in IT Carlow that I can sign up to?
You could do a course here, Rushing, all right?
Maths under pressure. It's not as easy as it seems. No. That's why I'm praying it doesn't go to penalties. Well, if ever there was an appropriate song for this game for both teams, this is it, isn't it? What do you think is being said in that huddle? Or is it all about just encouraging players now? Can you actually give them information that they will take on board?
No, look, I think it's just keep composure. I think it's just, look, we have two halves to go. It's going to come down to the wire. It's going to be a dogfight. It's beginning to rain out here. Conditions are going to get messy. You know, balls are going to slip out of our hand. It's going to come from the gut. And that's what both managers are saying. I don't think tactics-wise, you know, obviously to make some changes maybe during the game, but I think tactics-wise, it's not going to be. And I think the players, you can see the players, they're even taking on themselves. They're talking themselves. So it has to come from them. And it's really Fitzgibbon Cup hurling conditions here tonight. It's a dogfight, but this is what makes the competition so brilliant, and this is what makes it so amazing to win it, because it always is a dogfight. It's always a tough, hard battle to win these things, and that's what makes it so enjoyable.
Do UL have the momentum going in, or is that not a thing here. I mean, they got the equaliser, so in theory maybe they do. But
they got the equaliser. I think it was there for IT Carlow. I think they'll be a little bit more disappointed going in and maybe saying that we had it, especially after Marty Cavanagh getting the goal. So I'd say IT Carlow would be a little bit more subdued.
And the crowd aren't subdued. They don't care about the rain. They don't care about the cold. They're up for this. IT Carlow back on the pitch. Interestingly enough, IT Carlow went into the dressing rooms. UL stayed out there.
That is interesting, yeah, because like no one wants to stand out in the rain and you'll get cold and that's the last thing you want to do. And as well as that, I think being in a dressing room, you create a better atmosphere.
Brian Cody, he's seen some belters of matches down through the years. This absolutely no exception.
Yeah, he's taking it all in there. He's seen there any changes or anything.
I think he's updating his Instagram, is he? the chap beside him, I'd say, is.
Maybe it's a selfie he's taken of himself. Actually, it's hard to know.
Doesn't seem the type.
I don't think so.
By the way, a special mention for Conor Flaherty with that absolutely mesmerising point. Lost here last night in the Sigerson Cup final. Tonight he's kept his team in it.
Am I right in saying if they won that last night and if they won the Fitzgibbon on, this is only hypothetically speaking, on Saturday, he'd be the only man to do it? Sigerson and the Fitzgibbon? That's one for tomorrow, isn't it, for you.
Ball in, game on. Brian O'Grady. It's intercepted. Good play by Redmond. Ross Hayes on and eager to make an impression. Higgins fires it away long. How much of a difference will that rain make? We'll come back to that point in just a second because Corcoran has dispossessed Casey. Mike Goff. UL calmly playing it around, yeah. IT Carlow with that extra man. Podge Delaney trying to get out. Redmond. The other semi went to extra time as well, of course. Here's Dunbar. Oh, lets it slip. I was about to say, was he thinking goal? Might still be, but it won't come from him. Comes back to Dunbar. Higgins. Slots it over. Good score by Higgins.
Worked hard for it and made it harder than themselves. I thought Dunbar himself should have put it over the bar, but got the score in the end. You're talking about the rain, Oisín. I think it'll be a big difference because what happens when you're playing in the rain and there's lights on the field, it gets caught in your eye line and it's actually harder to catch the ball because there's rain coming down and the slitter.
And it's cold as well, which doesn't help. No clean catch there, but that's to be expected. Running onto it here is Brian O'Sullivan, but he can't take it cleanly. Jason Clear. Risky. Kiley doing his best to get this one back. Worked really hard to make sure IT Carlow didn't get it out. And now he's got it back. That's brilliant play from Mikey Kiley. Doesn't catch it cleanly. He was in a crowd, so that's no surprise. Bounces kindly for the goalkeeper. Howland from Shelmaliers in Wexford, the county football champions in Wexford. Wouldn't quite fall for Dunbar. Nolan does really well. Dunbar and Nolan queuing up for it. It is Dunbar who takes it eventually. Dunbar has goal on mind. Dunbar can't catch it cleanly. First time, can't catch it at all. Second time. And here's TJ Brennan.
Great defending, to be fair. Dunbar was true.
O'Grady. Great dispossession. Lovely little stroke in there by Kian Kenny. Chris Nolan. Free in for IT Carlow.
Chris Nolan is up for this match. He's playing a stormer all the way, the whole 60 minutes, and he's after starting really well as well. He's really leading that IT Carlow team. Great defending. Brian O'Mara there, getting back with that hook, because it's so hard, when you're batting the ball, it's very hard to hook a man.
UL making a change coming in. Shane Staunton of Clara in County Kilkenny. I think he's replaced Flaherty.
Nick Dempsey there in the background.
wide.
Unlike Seamus Casey.
Helped forward by Ross Hayes. Came on just before the end of normal time. Here's Mikey Kiley. Good turn by Kiley. Delaney not giving up on this one. Redmond helps him out. Kiley from the corner. Great stuff by Delaney. Niall Brazel will have time to dust that one off and fire it away. That was really good full back play.
Really good, yeah. Kiley is dangerous. Whenever he's a big strong man, he's really dangerous when he gets that ball. But great defending by Pod Delaney.
Corkin trying to get away from Dunbar. Very good ball to Kieran Connolly. Connolly from a long way out. It has the legs. Does it have the accuracy? No. In the end, I actually don't think it did either. That drops just short of the headline.
Didn't even go wide.
I think that breeze is picking up.
Yeah, and the rain, everything's going to be slippier now. So UL won't be scoring them long range scores that they were getting in the first half and second half.
Casey thought he kept it in play. He hasn't. Trying to take it back off him as Brian O'Grady. In front of a large and enthusiastic crowd.
Yeah, they're definitely getting into it now, the crowd as well. So it's going to make up for an interesting 20 minutes.
Aaron Claher just stepping out of picture there. He's our sideline official this evening from the Padraig Pearce's club in County Roscommon. Connacht Senior Club football champions this season. Of course, the dual club, though, successful in hurling and football. Mikey Kiley. Connolly. O'Grady's shot is blocked. IT Carlow throwing the bodies on the line.
Yeah, it's turning into a real dogfight now, Oisín. Conditions are going to play havoc.
Look at that. A normal human being would last approximately 1 second in there. Dunbar. And it's a free out.
Free out, yeah. He looked as if he looks as if he tripped him, I think, with the hurl by the looks of things.
It's TJ Brennan from Claren Bridge. The club of Alan Kearns. Sits up relatively nicely. It's a very good take. Is it to be a very good score? The answer is yes. Cian Galvin.
That's his third from play. Cian Galvin, he likes to get up the field.
I don't know how he does it, but he always just looks like he has so much time.
He does.
Higgins touches it down to himself brilliantly. Can he get a shot away? Yes, he can. Can he get a score? No, but it might work out. Oh, just got away from Marty Cavanagh. Nolan tries to win it back. Has he fouled Brennan? No, he hasn't. He's dispossessed him. Brennan did really well. Used his strength, used his guile. And uses his brain. Farmed away by Shane Staunton. Intercepted though. Here's Jason Clear. He's fouled. He had Brazel just behind him, but the free was coming.
Yeah, and as we spoke about the rain and conditions, that was a mishit shot, a clearance by Mike Gock, you know, and it fell down to the IT man, and rightly so, a free in being held back.
Yeah, Brian O'Sullivan from Kanturk just holding his man back on the way through. I'm going to double check this with you, but we are level, 26 points apiece.
We are level, Oisín, yeah. I'll tell you when it's a minute to go in extra time.
Thanks. Seamus Casey.
Yeah, the thought is going.
We're not level now. IT Carlow by a point. Drama wise, penalties will be entertaining, but you kind of don't want it to be decided that way.
No, I don't think anybody. Well, from a player's point of view, yeah. I don't think they do. From a sports point of view, I don't think I'd mind looking at a few penalties anyway.
In fairness, time in the calendar wise, there is no choice. You'd have to decide it some way tonight.
The whole fixture list is just up on top of each other.
Redmond. Out for another line ball. Right in front of that UL bench.
Trying to even find a piece of grass to put the ball on now is even a bit difficult because the pitch is sand-based, so with the rain it's going to make it twice as slippier.
NUIG, six-time winners. IT Carlow, zero-time winners. no guarantee, of course, that that will change this season, even if IT Carlow or UL were to win tonight. NUIG awaiting in the final. Who's going to get to the final?
NUIG are probably happy enough, to be fair, to this going to extra time, you know, but take the energy out of the teams.
That's intercepted brilliantly by Mike Goff. He read it well. He had Chris Nolan on top of him, so he had to. Connolly into the corner. Fergal Hayes gets there. Dunbar. That's a tired mistake.
I was just going to say Dunbar's really coming into it. You know, he's dropping deep. He's on a lot of ball, but that was a tired ball.
Kylie. They could be in here. It's lost. And it's a free rather than a penalty.
Yeah. I'm not too sure. I wouldn't mind seeing that again now.
Did Ross Hayes get lucky here? Because it looked to me like he lost it rather than he was fouled.
He lost the ball. Yeah, I thought he had the possession lost. He had possession lost, but I think Fergal Hayes came across a bit strong, but the possession was lost. He had the ball out of his hand.
Well, this one to level it up. Garrod O'Connor. We haven't had too many stoppages in this first period of extra time, so...
Very little.
I don't know if it'll be the last puck, but it might be the last score of this period of extra time. He's played well tonight, Garrod O'Connor. It wasn't quite the last puck, but as we predicted, it was the last score. All square at the end of extra time. Aidan Fogarty.
Yeah, like not in between these scenes, Oisín. You know, a low score in first 10 minutes. The rain was starting to pelt out of it there, just as the ball is thrown in. So conditions are very hard. You know, like there's absolutely not between the scenes. IT Carlow kind of got on top of UL. In fairness to Grona Connor, you look at, it's going to be freeze. It's going to be, you see the lazy ball there by Cathal Dunbar. You know, these small mistakes. That's what it's going to come down to. It's going to come down to a flick of a ball or, you know, something small like that. And look, it really is. The conditions here are really, really bad.
Redmond has a hand injury. Let's hope he's okay. Amy Horan is the physio. IT Carlow once again going into the changing rooms. And this time, UL have done the same. 221 to 27 points. Who's going to win this one? Your guess, as good as mine. Here's a couple of scores from the first period of extra time. Cian Galvin once again just stroking it over. Galvin, who during the lockdown did a fundraiser locally and raised an awful lot of money for charity.
Yeah. That was his project for lockdown. Fair play. That was a great score.
Fantastic. And now it's just the crowd and the tunes, the hurling. Taking a break for a couple of seconds while we wait for the second period of extra time.
Yeah, it's all or nothing in there now, Oisín. You know, there wasn't too many substitutions being made on either team, interesting enough. So they're really going with what they have, the 15 or 16 guys. It'll be interesting to see will they make calls like that.
Halftime and extra time. We'll be back for the conclusion of this game, whether that's just the second period of extra time or the second period of extra time and penalties. NUIG made to wait. But for the neutral fans watching this, I don't think they'll mind who has to wait. They just love it. They love what they're seeing. It's entertaining. We'll be back with the second period of extra time very shortly. Stay with us. UL back on the pitch. We're still waiting for IT Carlow. It's all square going into the second period of extra time. Anthony Nash, as excited and nervous as the rest of us, he's part of the UL management team. 27 points UL, 221 IT Carlow. Aidan Fogarty, formerly of IT Carlow, and of course at the time CIT, they're now known as MTU Cork Campus. It has been some games so far, hasn't it?
Absolutely brilliant. Look, it has it all. It kind of started a bit slow, but look, IT Carlow really got into the game. UL threw everything at them. We had goal chances, we had goals, we had points disallowed, we had extra time, and look, it was a low scoring first half of extra time, only 2 points from each side. So look, I don't think this half is going to be more than that either. So two teams very tired, conditions not great. It's going to be a battle.
Certainly will be. And immediately a foul called. IT Carlow with the free, and given the way that Seamus Casey has been knocking them over tonight, you wouldn't be surprised if he launched this one.
You wouldn't be surprised, yeah, but as I just mentioned, condition-wise, the towel is going on, he's going to wipe the grip. Dead straight in front of the goal, to be fair, but still out a good bit.
It has started to bucket down a bit. It was calm and balmy earlier on.
Still was the shorts weather all the same, machine.
That, well, that's true. Casey to give IT Carlow the lead. Can't keep it on frame, and yeah. IT Carlow can't keep it in play.
It's just that slippy ball, you could even see it kind of slide off the hurl. Conditions are making it difficult, but still a draw game, and look, it's all to play for.
A tiny swirl in the breeze, not as strong as you might have expected earlier in the day, considering we were hearing about nothing but storm warnings. Here's Brazel. One brilliantly out in front, it's Cody. Dispossessed by his clubmate Corcoran. That's what this competition is all about. Connolly. Great block.
Brilliant hook.
Well, that gives you an indication as to how heavy the rain is. This is worth another look. Pursued all the way by Redmond. It was a hook rather than a block, you're right. You spotted that. The eagle eyes of Aidan Fogarty.
Things like that now, like that's a turnaround for IT. It's not going to be on the scoreboard. It's going to be in the tackles. It's going to be the hooks. It's going to be in the blocks.
Not shorts weather, you said.
He must be out from the swimming pool, that man.
He gets some air on those line balls. Just didn't quite fall for Marty Kavanagh. TJ Brennan took it. Brilliant take it was as well. O'Mara. O'Grady tries to get away from Brazel, who loses his hurley. Lovely little flip outside, pancake-esque to Ross Hayes. Intercepted. Great work. Taken coolly by Jason Clear. Back to Clear. Clear has time and space, and then out of nowhere, Dara Corcoran appears. Kylie. Kylie does really well.
Out the field a good bit, Kylie. They need him in the square.
Connolly, I think it gets caught in the breeze. The players not really adjusting for it in the last couple of minutes. It's got stronger as the game has gone on. Fergal Hayes. Good ball out in front. Clear takes off. I beg your pardon, that's Redmond. Nolan and TJ Brennan, they've really gone at it. That's not a foul. They both slipped. Brennan.
Them two guys are having some battle all night.
Brennan has fouled it to free out. You can see it with Mikey Kiley. Anytime he gets the ball in close confines, he can get it out of contact really well. Here is just a really good full forward, full back battle, isn't it? Yeah. TJ Brennan and Chris Nolan.
Two of them going at it.
I say Kiley is a forward, but you can see him dropping back to get those short passes out of defence all the time. Owen Davis goes long. What a catch that is. Kian Galvin again. Short.
What a take. Brilliant catch.
Niall Brennan is back in. He's the kind of guy who can take pressure scores from a long way out, so I can understand why UL would have brought him back in.
Yeah.
Brian O'Mara. Ross Hayes can't dig it up off the turf. It's getting really tough to get clean possession in these conditions. You can see it's very, very heavy rain-wise. Samson, great pass by Samson. Mikey Kiley, but there is a free the other way.
Through the ball.
And rarely do you see that given. It happens all the time, but rarely do you see it given.
Yeah, it did look like a throw.
Yeah.
It did look like a throw.
It was the right call, there's no doubt about that.
Yeah,
but
right call.
So that's it confirmed. Niall Brennan back in. You can see the Pride logo on the jerseys, so fair play to you, UL, for that.
No score yet.
Inclusion, such an important part of the college experience. Great catch by TJ Brennan, trying to get away from Owen Cody. He's fouled, it's a free out. This is not a criticism of either team. It's got very scrappy, very bitty, isn't it?
No, very scrappy, yeah. Look, it's freeze. The whole flow, the momentum has gone out of the game. And that's probably just counter conditions, down to tiredness. Can't fault the players whatsoever.
Owen Davis. Batted down by Galvin. They know if he gets any time or space, he will shoot. Jason Clear.
Both sets of backs really on top. None of the forwards are getting there.
Higgins away from Sampson. Higgins with a wonderful score.
Brilliant individual score.
In such a tight game, that could be huge for IT Carlow. And now they lead by one.
You could nearly say by T. Carlow, will they just keep it at one now and push everyone back?
Well, it's been so tight.
It has been so tight, yeah.
Breaks for Niall Brennan. He was brought on to take shots and get points. I've no doubt about that. Jason Clear.
This man is coming into it now, in fairness, in the last 10 minutes as well. The half-back line of Carlow IT really mopping up ball.
Brazel. I think that was Kavanagh who came out to meet it, but he just couldn't get a hold of it. It was an old school pull on the ball and it went a long, long way.
You don't see that.
Redmond has to be careful in his. That's a great pass and a great take. Delaney leaves it behind, but Dunbar tries to sweep it up. There was Redmond as well. Falls somehow to Delaney, but again, he can't get it up. Here's Dunbar. Did an extra man back there. It's Brian O'Mara who just launches this. But it doesn't have the legs. That wind is really catching the players out. And when conditions change during a game, Aidan, that makes it really difficult for the players, doesn't it?
It absolutely does. Like, you know, in fairness to Brian O'Mara, you know, he probably fancied himself from distance. You know, he's seen Keane Galvin getting ones from distance. But all that has changed now because the conditions have changed. But it's hard to adapt that when you're actually playing the game. You just don't think about it. You just think, well, it should go over because I put him over in the first half.
Conor O'Grady of Limerick is in. 1 point in the second period of extra time so far. That came from Higgins. Nolan lets it off for Redmond. Redmond cushions it. Great ball. Kenny. Cody. Falls for the keeper, who's pressurised by Kavanagh. Keeper does very well. Good use of the feet. Away by O'Mara. Intercepted, but it's there to be fought for again. Niall Brazel, free out. Another big win for IT Carlow.
Big win for IT Carlow. And as I mentioned already, the half-back line of the IT Carlow are playing excellent. Niall Brazel there, Jason Clear, clearing a lot of ball in the last 7 or 8 minutes. Big momentum swings, you know, and this sucks the life out of the other team, you know, and brings down the time as well. DJ looking very anxious. Marty Kavanagh coming all the way back to take this.
I know there's a long time to go, and I know this game has been full of twists and turns, but if he gets this, it could be the winner.
It could be the winner. Look, they're a pint up with only a minute and a half to go, and scores aren't that easy to get.
Kavanagh, who's got the goal off the bench. I don't know, does it have the legs, but it might drop. Who will it drop to? The goalkeeper, they're lucky. Now it's the time to work it short. Connolly. It was a little bit loose. IT Carlow had a man back and he was able to take it up without any issues. Niall Brazel thought about pucking it long. Went with the handbass to Dunbar. Dunbar, who's going for it. Dunbar, this could be the winner if it goes over, which it hasn't done.
I thought the crowd thought it.
The crowd thought it was going over. I thought it was going over. The umpires who have the better view said it didn't go over. Here's Cian Kenny. They don't need to score, they just need to hang on to it. I know that's not really a hurling thing, but even if they could keep it at that end of the pitch, they'd be doing okay.
Keep it down on the attacking end, yeah.
That rain has got significantly worse during the game. TJ Brennan, whatever he's doing, he needs to do it quickly.
He needs to hurry on.
They have to work it. A point will do, that will bring it to penalties. The goalkeeper has plenty of room to come into here. Owen Davis.
Last chance.
They're going direct. IT Carlow have far more back than UL have forward. Will it fall to Illuminous Green or White? At the moment, IT Carlow winning that particular battle. That's Delaney of Leash. The fullback wins the ball, gets it to Nolan. Cody. Cody had plenty of options. That was a brilliant pass to Higgins. Higgins! That could
That's
be
it.
That. Higgins, who's got 2 points in extra time, the second period of it, may well have just sent IT Carlow through to their third ever Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup final. In this game, though, you never say never. And it's not over until John Keenan blows that full-time whistle.
He's not playing. He's playing a risky
Redmond,
game.
He's hooked. It's back with UL and Ross Hayes, who's fouled. It's a free in. Now, what do you do here? I imagine they'll ask the referee what's left.
What's left? Oisín, I think he's going to have to go for it. Time is up. Time is up, he's after saying, so he has to go for it.
Mikey Kiley, who has a hammer shot.
How many shots have we seen in the last couple of weeks that have gone in? Last minute, die hard.
Does he aim for the crossbar or does he just go for power? Mikey Kiley, this is it. It's in!
I don't believe it.
Mikey Kiley didn't give it everything. He kind of dipped it towards the crossbar.
Like,
Paul Flynn-esque.
Just like as if he put a bit of topspin on it or something. That's it.
And that is that. UL somehow have found a way. It's another dramatic late finish to a big, big game. This is the moment. This is the goal. Now, did it take a touch on the way through?
It took a dip.
UL don't care.
No one got a touch to it.
No one got a touch. Galvin spun at it, but he don't think he got anything on it. Mikey Kiley with a miracle goal for UL. It is UL against NUIG in the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup final here on Saturday. A man Mikey Kiley is. Look at him going around to the IT Carlow players.
Absolutely brilliant. Our Mikey Kiley, you know, last gasp. Goal, like as I just said it, how many times have you seen this in the last couple of weeks? Late goals by TJ Reid, Ruddle only last week, and now you have Mikey Kiley to go down in the history books for UL with a late goal.
Mikey Kiley emulating Paul Flynn.
Absolutely, yeah.
Aim for the crossbar,
aim for
dip
the crossbar,
it.
Dip it.
Like, that wasn't him just giving it all the power he had. That was him saying, you know what, the only chance I have here is if I dip it.
Absolutely, and you know what made that goal? Keane Galvin made a swing at it and just took the defender out of it, and the defender would have blocked it. Keane Kenny just swung at it. He didn't even want to hit the ball, but he just wanted to let the ball go through. Brilliant piece of play by Keane Galvin, wing back.
Mikey Kiley with a goal that I think will be remembered forever. UL 127, Carlow 223. UL are through to the Electric Ireland Fitzgibbon Cup final. Well, we've had quite the night here. It is worth watching back in full before Saturday's final, which is live on TG Catter, I might say. My thanks to Aidan Fogarty for coming along tonight and witnessing a dramatic game with me.
Thank you.
And my thanks to all the crew who put this game together and put the broadcast together in incredibly, incredibly tough conditions. It's a tough, tough night for IT Carlow. They're out in really horrendous circumstances. UL, I don't know if they will go home. I don't know if they'll stay around here. But either way, they are back here on Saturday when they will play NUIG in the decider. As I say, it's live on TG Cahir. That's it from IT Carlow. Hard luck to them. Well done to UL. Thank you for watching. We'll see you soon.